Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to Madden 18 on EA Sports.
The Colts, it's a day's game. It's a battle between two teams who come in with opposite win-loss totals on the year. It's the Jets going up against the Colts.
Thank you, Larry. We welcome you to the heart of the Hoosier State in the Circle City of Indianapolis, Indiana, and Lucas Oil Stadium. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he'd taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Between the New York Jets and the Indianapolis Colts. First run back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
When trying to create space for your running back, the first thought is how physical is the offensive line. Sometimes it's just positioning. On that play, it didn't matter about positioning or being physical. The defensive front, they out leveraged them and won the battle.
Second down, Bridgewater. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Indianapolis moving the chains there on a gain of 12. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his. Let's go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Yeah, that was a safety that came through and made the play. But there's no doubt in my mind, he hits like a linebacker, and we see a lot of that in today's NFL, don't we?
And that time, we do indeed. A big hit for a loss. He's going to air one out. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Third down, Bridgewater. Throw left side, complete to Ingram. A 14-yard gain for Indianapolis, and also moved the sticks. Just the first quarter, but tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent, and they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. I ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I had missed him, it would have been a
different story.
Long night.
So the offense has it first and 10. Bridgewater now. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker Jordan Jenkins. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. They were ball hawks last week. They had a trio of interceptions on defense. In the first drive, they pick up right where they left off.
They're creating quite a reputation for themselves, aren't they? And sometimes what happens is when they know that the defense can take the ball away as they saw the previous week, now you try too hard to not let them take it away, and you force yourself into errors.
And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Devontae Freeman with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Jets have taken a first quarter lead.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
Oh, and now he bowls him over. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too caught.
They'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. Muhammad Wilkerson in there to bring him down, and that is sack number 17 for him now on the year. A second down throw for Bridgewater. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. A very solid gain of 27. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't they?
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
And that's why defensive coaches preach swarming to the football. It's usually going to take more than one guy to get that big man down.
And it did right there. Multiple broken tackles, but they eventually get him down. So third and two. This quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. Give the Colts 13 yards at a first down.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Heck of a broken tackle and able to work this down near the 23. A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a second and 3. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far is working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. They always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back at the 21-yard line.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is to get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
And now running right through it. 8 yards there and a first down.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down.
And he's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. Good bounce back drive right there through the pick on drive number one. Drive number two leads them right down the field into the end zone.
Agree totally. Excellent bounce back, tremendous poise, confidence never lost, and obviously he transmitted that to his teammates as well. What a really nice drive.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. Time for our first check of the NFL scoreboard. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. He lost six there on the first down play. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it up, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open.
I think defensively, you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
On third down, he'll drop the throw. But he's got a noon one. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a jet first down. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot.
Throw now on first down. He's got Freeman here. It's complete. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second down. Now a handoff. It's Freeman. And he is going to be knocked flat on his back. Oh, a big hit. Looks to be right around the 40. I'm no offensive mastermind, but of all the guys on the field to block, you might want to stop him.
Look, I've got a very simple rule. An unblocked defender is usually your best defender, and he ended up making the play there.
They'll look to throw. And it's complete to Kelce. Well, he's taken down, but not before picking up the first thanks to a flashy little spin move. The jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. Throw here on first down. Caught. Kelce, left side. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. I know when you got a top tight end like this, you want to get him involved, but when you do, you're hoping for more than that.
You certainly are. You've got to try and get him some space where he can make a play downfield, or at least an opportunity for some rack yardage, right, that run after catch.
They're going to look to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. He was looking for Dante Moncrief that time. Third down here.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Now back to throw. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. The jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe tapping, and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
Here we go. Grand 38. Grand 38. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Back to throw now on first down. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Second down, Freeman. He'll get it inside the red zone, but only for a couple down to the 19.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball in this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
The Jets on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. On the run, it's McNichols. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Freeman fighting his way in for a Jets touchdown. Devontae Freeman, his 2nd touchdown of the game and his 9th on the year. And the Jets have taken the lead. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Around the NFL, we've got a 2nd quarter score. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. And we'll keep you abreast of how that one shakes out. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he probably should have stayed in the end zone as he'll muster a return up to only the 14-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll lose yardage on this one, back to the 13. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down.
If it's not one guy, it's another with this defense. I mean, this is the #1 unit against the rush in the entire NFL. They know how to cover for each other. And, yeah, they've got great players. They also have very dependable players, too.
Bridgewater now on 2nd down. And he's got his man on the out route. And he's out of bounds right at the 25. 1:59 to go in the 1st half. We'll come back to Indianapolis right after this. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. Handoff as they run the counter play. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And that'll make it 2nd and 12. From the gun, Bridgewater. He's going to float this one deep right side. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the 1st half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. The Colts on 3rd down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is 3rd down and 12. To throw, Bridgewater. Trying to lay one up deep. And a shot. Shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
Fans do love the long ball, don't they? And he already found his guy once. Tried to give him another chance there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Couldn't connect, but as you alluded to, he does have that touchdown from earlier, trying to keep him in the rhythm. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Taken in at the 22. And he is knocked down and then landed on pretty awkwardly. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Jets will take over first and 10. They are in the second quarter down in Miami, and it's an early lead there for the Saints. And we'll keep an eye on that one as our game goes along here. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Now they go screen. It's complete. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And he's brought down, but not before getting across midfield to the 45. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Here we go.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And he's brought down. 10 yards is the pickup. Good enough for a Jet first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. I think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Let's go! One, nine.
Now a play fake here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And he's got some space here. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Second down to the offense needing 5 yards. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And that one was nearly picked. Not sure he was accounting for the free safety. That brings up third down. They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You're dropping eight. Where are you going to go with the football?
Gun now on third down. Dancing to his left. He may try and run for this. Only able to get back a yard for his efforts, and that leads us to fourth down. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. Spotted at the left hash, this from 45. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. So we have come upon. So no update from Larry after 17 weeks. Folks are saying, let's get on with the show. So we'll oblige as we get you set for the second half kickoff. Around the NFL, we've got a second quarter score. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor. Now the Jets offense about set to take over as they head onto the field. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys. But be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And he's brought down after a good game. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Here we go. 38.
They toss to Freeman. He finds some open field here. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Give him 12 yards there, and the Jets have a first.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral, also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other bats in the league.
Freeman again, a first down carry. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Big boys down there in the trenches, and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big time play there.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Here we go! What? Ohio! Ohio!
And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Back to throw. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Here's Lachlan Edwards now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. He punted four times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds, and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room.
And that's caught inside the 30. And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line. A big play there for Indy. 58 yards. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Bridgewater. And he slings one that's incomplete. But not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
On second down, Bridgewater again. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro corner, Josh Norman. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
You're looking there at a defensive back who's maybe a step slower than he was when he came into the league a decade ago. I know I questioned his speed coming into the game, but what he's lost in speed, he's more than made up for it with intellect. And that's a great job of knowing how to position himself to make that interception.
Come on, let's go!
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Buying time to his left. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Over to the right side, caught by Moncrief. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Now the offense lining up first and 10. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Flushed out right. A right side catch by Crabtree. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Broke through some contact, but unable to reach the 40. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Completes it to Moncrief left side. The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. First down, he'll drop to throw it. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. It's a 4-yard pickup, and it'll make it a second down. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. On the give, this is their fullback. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down? Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Devontae Freeman. And brought down, but the juke, the very nice juke, gives him the first down yardage there. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And a pickup of about 4 down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Shift together here from the D-line. Here's McNichols, and this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
Brandon, this is clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth.
Back now here on EA Sports. It's Jet football as they've got the lead here, and we get set to begin quarter number 4.
Let's go!
On third down. That's Freeman, and they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. They lost a big chunk, 6 yards there, and it leads to fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. And Bryant's kick is good, and that will open the lead up now to 20-7. So they settle for just the 3 there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But 3 does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. And the Colts coming out now. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part 2, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back.
And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A big play there.
with touchdown number 23 here on the year. And the Colts have got it back to a one-score game. And it's good. The deficit 6, 20-14. Gonzalez now to kick this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The New York set to take the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the three-point
kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe
super toe.
Flush to his right. And now a fumble. The ball's out. And I believe the Colts have recovered. Yes, they have.
Well, that takeaway, partner, right there, that's a combination of coaching, execution, and absolute belief. Because a lot of guys will look at the scoreboard and go, this thing's pretty well done. But they still thought to themselves, if we could make a play, we give our team, we give our teammates a chance to win it. And that's exactly what they did.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give the Colts 13 yards and a first down. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. Going to give this time to the tailback. And they'll get to him just inside the 15, even after that strong run we witnessed. A gain of 3, second down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave them with a third and about 5.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Bridgewater from the gun on third down. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. The decision to go for it pays off, and now they're set up first and goal. First and goal at the 3-yard line now. They'll come out in the pistol. And he'll give it here to his running back. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop it right around the 1.
To me, that's a terrific run on first and goal at the 3. They got 2 yards. I'd line right back up and give it to him again.
Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Offense looks to punch it in here. And he takes it in for a Colts score. A great play there. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Colts can now take the lead if they convert the extra point. And they have taken the lead here in this 4th quarter. Gonzalez now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. And New York set to take the field. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores, that can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
They're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. And he'll get about three here as he's out to the 30.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
7 yards to go on second down.
Let's go! Brian 38!
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. The Colts are going to get him. Down he goes. Solomon Thomas in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long.
Here we go. One, nine. Ohio. Ohio. Quit.
He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. The clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
The Jets on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This will be third and forever. They'll drop the throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line.
Well, it's third and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it. And this time, it results in an interception.
Now they'll run it on the toss. Down right around the 25. Give them 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. So the offense now dealing with a 2nd and 7. Bridgewater now. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
Oh, he caught it. Just couldn't get the feet down. Couldn't get that toe-tap sequence, right? I was ready to call him tippy-toes if that one was completed.
Tagger! Tagger! Let's go!
Bridgewater to throw. Going for it all. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's 4.
There's definitely contact there, but it's the fourth quarter of a kind of tight game, and sometimes the officials just say, let them play. Kind of like your mom used to, you and your brothers, just take the broom to you and send you out to the backyard and tell you to settle it yourselves.
I like that, yeah. There was contact. I don't know, like you said, enough to warrant the flag.
It was close, though. And Gonzalez puts this one through, and the drive will wind up yielding 3. So they get the 3 here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten 6 out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
The New York set to take the field. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. He's back to throw. Now a desperation throw. He's got a man complete. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. And that one results in 35 yards. Back to throw. It's caught by Moncrief. And he's going to get this inside the 30. The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
He'll look to throw. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Freeman. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll make it a second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Come on, let's go! Pass 38! Check round! Flex round! Ohio! Ohio!
Back to throw! Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Quincy Anunua that time, and it's third and short.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. The Jets on third down, 5 out of 9 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? Yeah, he got a little aggressive too early.
And he did, wanting that quick takeoff as the ball was snapped, but I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
Point in the game. Solomon Thomas in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. They'll look to throw. This is caught. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Travis Kelce in the final minute. And the Jets have taken the lead here in the 4th quarter.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. This defense has watched their lead dwindle away. This is where they really need to bow up. They executed well there.
And it's often hard after you've played really well early and then you kind of relax a little bit to step on the gas again. They just did it on the last play. Looks like they want to finish this one off.
Looking left side and it's complete. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. Here's Bridgewater. He's going to let it fly. A swing pass caught. Now they get the timeout. It leads you to wonder, will they kick it here or risk running another play and possibly not getting down in time? We'll see. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now Bridgewater steps away to his left. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. So that one, a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that can be the make or break difference on a play. This time he had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. Got caught for the penalty.
So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. And his kick is good. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score...
So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. They'll bring it back to just about the 25. Call it the 24-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition, let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Short gain there to start overtime.
Almost a tester play, wasn't it? Wanted to see if the guys on defense were going to fit the gaps the correct way, because we're in overtime. So it's not just physical tiredness out there, right? Mentally, are you still doing what you're supposed to do? And they were up to the task on that play.
And certainly fatigue on both sides of the football. Oh, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Vontae Davis. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a jack. Time, that's one thing. It was a great...
Let's go! Interception, baby! Let's go!
Yeah, you know I've been ballin'. Yeah, you know I've been ballin'. Every day I'm shot callin'. I'm a spray, make it rain, just to let you know I've been ballin'. Yeah, I've been ballin'. Yeah, just to let you know. Yeah.
you know.